Yep.
The next student, unfortunately, cannot be here with us, but it's Edin Toprak. She did an awesome job, and we do want to show it for you guys. So we're going to play her video for you, and you're not going to be able to ask questions on that. But we would be glad to answer the questions. So we're just going to play the video for you.
Is a solar panel speaker that connects to your phone and plays music. My milestone was creating a 3D printed case that would hold all of my wires and my circuitry together in one place. What was really cool about this milestone is that I got to look at my design, and the first time I printed it, the filament got stuck. And I realized there were some modifications I needed to do to my design in order to really get it to the place where I wanted it to be. Okay, so the next time around, I had added the rim to the side to hold the phone, and the printer didn't really understand what I was saying, so it printed all these like zigzag lines, basically saying, I don't know what you want me to do. And I fixed that problem and I got this. So this wall was thicker, and this would fit the phone, but with the extension cord that I ordered, it didn't go through and also fit the phone. So I have to modify this, and I made it longer. I made this wall thinner for the LEDs to go through, and I made sort of like a wall to hold the phone so it wouldn't fall over when the speaker was moving. I have to think of my modification in advance, which is the microphone that listens to the music and the LEDs light up to put the holes into my case. And the lid I printed many times because at first I forgot the hole for the solar panel wire to go through, and then my box kept, I resized it to make it bigger, so the lids were too small, and then finally I ended up with the right one. Yay, go Blue Sam! Basically determine what LEDs should light up. One thing that I'm not sure about, but I think, is that the LEDs light up due to different frequencies, so different colors light up at different times, or due to different sounds. In the future, if someone did want to do this exact project, I would use as stiff of wires, and to put the LEDs in, when you solder the jumper wires to the strands of the LEDs, before you put them in, you should wrap them in electrical tape, just so they don't short when they're so close together in the box. Also, as you can see, my box turned out to be not as well organized as I wanted it to be. So I would recommend maybe leaving a little bit more space for the wires, or connecting, not making this wall so close to the LEDs, causing them to short. In the end, I wouldn't have done this project the way I did because LEDs don't work so well in the sun. They're not meant to. As my modification, I would have made it run on battery instead of adding the extra LEDs. Right.
So we'll do...
The LEDs are lighting up, light up better when the music is playing. And here's it working!